Located in 133 Rosenau Hall, the Joan Heckler Gillings Auditorium is equipped with 5 ceiling-mounted projectors, 6 wall-mounted collaboration monitors, a ceiling-mounted reference monitor, a lectern, and a media shelf. The media shelf contains a touchscreen control panel, monitor, wireless keyboard and mouse, document camera, Blu-ray DVD player, lavalier clip-on microphone, cables for connecting a laptop, a PowerPoint remote for advancing slides, and a wireless tablet control panel that is available for checkout from AV Services. There is also an AV help phone. Use the AV help phone if you need assistance in the room. The help phone will automatically dial AV Services when you pick up the handset. Touch the control panel screen to access the room controls. To select a source to display, tap an icon from the vertical list of options on the right side of the control panel. In a few seconds, the selected source will appear in the monitor to the left of the control panel and in the ceiling reference monitor. To send the source image to another display location, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor in the room. Blue squares with letters correspond to LCD projector locations. Red squares with numbers correspond to wall monitor locations. When a projector is selected, the projection screen will lower automatically and the projector will turn on after a few seconds. This room has a customized ceiling-mounted microphone system. These microphone levels are preset and not adjustable, but they can be muted. There is also a clip-on microphone that has an adjustable volume. To access these controls, press the audio button at the bottom of the control panel. Press the plus and minus to change the volume of the lavalier mic. Press the mute button to mute and unmute the audio. Tap the mute all microphones button to mute all of the room mics. Press again to unmute. Press the mute audience microphones button to only mute the mics above the seating areas of the auditorium. Press the button again to unmute. To access the room lighting controls, tap the lights icon at the bottom left of the control panel. Adjust the brightness for each tier of seats by tapping the desired setting. To adjust the window shades, tap the shades icon at the bottom left of the control panel. Press the open or close button for each side of the auditorium as desired. Press the desktop icon to select desktop as the display source. The desktop image will appear in the monitor to the left of the control panel and in the ceiling reference monitor. To send the computer image to another display location, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor. Use the wireless keyboard and mouse to operate the PC. Use the USB port located above the media shelf to load your files. To use the PowerPoint remote, power it on using the switch on the left side of the unit. Press the right arrow button of the remote to advance slides. Use the left arrow button to go backwards. Press the green marked button to use the built-in laser pointer. If needed, adjust the computer loudness by tapping the plus or minus for the desktop volume. Press the mute button to mute or unmute the PC audio. Connect your laptop using one of the cables on the left side of the media shelf. Use the media shelf's power outlets to power your laptop. Press the laptop icon on the control panel to select laptop as the display source. The laptop image will appear in the monitor beside the control panel and in the ceiling reference monitor. To send the laptop image to another display location in the room, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor. Touch the laptop volume plus or minus to toggle the laptop volume up or down. Touch the mute button to mute the audio. Press it again to unmute. Tap the wireless connection icon on the control panel to select it as the source to display. In a few seconds, the home screen for the wireless main wireless display unit will appear on the monitor next to the control panel and in the ceiling reference monitor. Follow the instructions on the home screen to install the VIA app by Kramer if using a Mac or PC. If using an iPhone or iPad, install the VIA Reveal app. When prompted by the app, enter the room name and code listed on the wireless main home screen. To send the wireless image to a display location in the room, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor. Touch the wireless main volume plus or minus to adjust the volume up or down. Touch the mute button to mute the audio. Press it again to unmute. Press the Blu-ray button on the right side of the touchscreen control panel. Insert your disc into the Blu-ray DVD player unit located on the media shelf. Use the playback controls on the touch panel. Touch the Blu-ray volume plus or minus to adjust the Blu-ray volume up or down. Touch the mute button to mute the audio. Press it again to unmute. To send the DVD image to a display location in the room, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor. The document camera is located on the media shelf. To use the document camera, unfold the unit and lift up the camera arm. Press the power button on the top of the unit. If needed, press the light button to turn on the document camera's light. Press the autofocus button to focus the camera automatically. Use the plus and minus buttons to zoom in and out. To send the document camera image to a display location, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor. Tap the Collaborate icon. The control panel screen will change to show the six wireless collaboration units in the room, each represented by a white square located beside a numbered wall monitor. Select a wireless unit by tapping a white square. To send the wireless image to a display location in the room, tap the number or letter that corresponds to the desired projector or monitor. Click the Zoom icon on the computer desktop and select Sign In. Use your UNC Onion and password to sign in to Zoom. Click the Meetings tab in the Zoom window to select and start your pre-scheduled meeting. Or use the Join option on the Zoom client to connect to your meeting. When prompted, click Join with Computer Audio to connect the microphones and speakers in the room. Use the desktop volume to adjust the volume of your remote participants. Use the camera button to set the camera angle for the front camera or the audience camera. To record the meeting, click the record button in the Zoom meeting interface and select Record to the Cloud. Recording to the cloud will save a backup copy of the recording in your Panopto account. If you have questions about using Zoom, please visit sph.unc.edu/IIS/Zoom or contact AV Services at 919-966-6536. Email sph_AV@unc.edu. Please press the Room Shutdown button at the bottom right corner of the control panel when you are finished using the technology. Confirm shutdown by pressing Yes when prompted.